Buenos dias, Gunners Collective TV. Back at it? You already know. Like a motherfucking smack at it. Bye, in a minute, let's start in direct fashion, man. We're going to get straight to it. But before we do, and you've seen that thumbnail, so you already know what it is. This is a laughing matter. Hit that like and subscribe, man. Put your notification bell on also. That way you're directed to the dope content that I am kicking. And I highly appreciate all the support that I've been getting. Gracias, man. Thank you guys so much. Man, it's getting real Mickey tricky, cuz. On 50-50, baby snap. Hey, it looks like a whole bunch of casted characters are going to hit Baby Snap's alley, man, and handle their business, right? Because we've been lied to. We've been bamboozled, befuddled. It's YouTube, eh? You know me? What do you expect? What the fuck do we expect as gente, as people that are only watching entertainment to be entertained, right? This is the type of shit that happens. So anyways, man, this back and forth shit between Adam 16 and China Mac, it's been going on for the last couple days, man. They've been going, China Mac said, get my whole Chinese dick and put it in your mouth, right? He said Adam had his whole shit in his mouth, meaning that Adam was jocking him at one point in time, and actually asked China Mac, you know, to be a part of No Jumper. Who hasn't he asked to be a part of No Jumper? That Vato's on his grind, man. You can't knock the hustle. That Vato will go up to any bum on the corner, man, that has a tattoo on his neck. So you're a gang member, right? You're from Roland, whatever? Would you mind rolling over to the studio and telling me your life story? Right? And that's how it goes. You know, or fuck my old lady. Would you want to fuck my old lady? Right? I could pay you in weed or pussy. You know what I mean? So either way, that's the way Adam rolls, man. He finds these guys that their trajectory is going up and he likes to put them in the pot of gumbo, stir it up a little bit. Toma, there you go. Anyone who has a little street credibility or maybe has their own channel, he's done it when Duno had his own channel. Now Duno has his own channel again. But you see how he went and went, Mexican power, brother, right? He went and snatched Duno up and added him to the cast. Of course, he's seen Sharp. He said, man, the pimping is real. He's seen Sharp do a video on fucking Soft White Underbelly. Next thing you know, Sharp's on that motherfucker like, hey, cat, you know me? And that was it. That's what he does. Shit, remember? Do you guys remember? I remember. Do you remember when he went and snatched up little Kelpie? Kelpie gets beat up all on his set. And I mean, anything for views, right? Anything. So anyways, with this going back and forth with China Mac, man, a lot of things are being exposed. A lot of the true bullshit that goes on behind the scenes at No Jumper and other places as well is being exposed, to which most of us that have common sense and are smart enough to understand the game know, right? But there's one incident in particular that Adam is starting to, he's going to expose the game. He's pulling the cobijas. He's basically going to let everybody know what time it is, right? You know, and this right here is hate with the capital H. Straight up. No, not Hoover with the H. Hate with the capital H, right? Because this guy has decided that if for no other reason, gente, he was going to go ahead and pull the covers on the AD, you know, China Mac fight. Now, I'm going to be totally honest with you, man. I've been in plenty of fights in my lifetime. You know, I've seen plenty of things go on behind the scenes. And I, myself, just my opinion, truly and honestly feel that AD, being a real one and knowing what I know about him through a lot of people, what I've seen, what I've heard, the respect he's given, how people treat him with respect, how real ones have said he's a real dude. And China Mac, likewise, pretty much the same thing I've heard. He has found himself in some Mickey situations, guys. But other than that, man, he's been as real as it gets. He's gaining so much credibility with what he's doing now with Crip Mac trying to help him. I believe they did fight. Adam's saying that it was staged, Holmes. It never happened. That this was all staged to gain views and get everybody's attention. Wow. So you can't be the hero and at the same time the villain, see? You can't expose this shit now.
Okay, oh, you don't like me? You want to talk about my ass and your dick? Okay, all right. You didn't even fight,
right? Where was this energy at months ago, a year ago, when this shit went down, when Adam is sitting there agreeing, oh, yeah, yeah, they fought, man, yeah, yeah, you know? Come on, man, stop manipulating the masses. When is this shit ever going to get played out as far as trying to manipulate people into viewing? You know, be old school, be real. Either they watch your shit or they don't. You can't dictate nobody's program, man. You're not that one, okay? Either people respect your channel, they are entertained by it, the people that you bring on entertain them and they watch it. But stop, this is Hollywood, homie. Stop that bullshit. You know, stop that Will Smith slap shit, bro. You know what I mean? You're either Will and got talent and we fuck with you. You know what I mean? But we're not going to fuck with you because of something that you've done, man, that dramatized. You know, nah, it's very dramatic. So anyways, now he's saying that the AD and China Mac fight wasn't real, that it was staged, that it never happened. Me being the way I am and being able to see somebody after they fought, I can tell you right now, something happened. Whether it was a slap box match, they were bear hugging each other. Someone had someone in the guillotine, right? Or Vatos fucking had races back and forth, the 40-yard dash. China Mac looked out of breath and a little red in some places. Okay, AD's hand definitely was scraped. Now, this is what we're going to do, okay? We're going to find some guy that's all tatted down to just make it look good. And China Mac, what you're going to do is you're going to do some burpees in the corner, and I'm just going to scrape my hand on the fucking wall, and we're going to show that and trick everyone so that everyone thinks we're real ones. I don't believe so. I believe they handled their business like men because they did have, you know, a difference of opinion. They did voice their opinions online. And it's crazy because the reason why a lot of us, they gained a lot of respect in the eyes of people who didn't know them was because of this fight. Let's just keep it truthful and real, you know. But meanwhile, Adam was a willing participant to agree with, oh, yeah, that's what I heard. You got any footage of it? You know what I mean? He always wanted footage because he always wanted to gain the max amount of value of views that he could. Of course, if there was a camera footage of this actual fight that actually took place, you can't really post it on YouTube, but somehow, some way, motherfuckers would have figured a way to manipulate it and put it out there. And then everyone could see what happens. But real ones that get into it, that handle their business like grown men, don't need to film it. Don't need to fucking, this is not no fucking Dr. Dre video, you know what I mean? You know, it's like this and like that and like this and it ain't nothing like that, homie. You handle your business, bare knuckle shit, bare knuckle brawling, and then you step. You know, if you choose to show everybody what you're about, if you guys choose to do that, that's up to you as grown men, but that's a choice that I'm sure both of you guys will come together and make. You both fought. There was two sides to every story, right? There's no reason Adam should be anywhere in that mix, but he is exposing it. So basically what Adam's saying is that these guys never fought. It was staged, and it was only to trick the people into feeling sympathetic and saying, oh shit, AD, you're real as fuck, or oh shit, China Mac, you're fucking super real, right? And he's saying that's how China Mac gained his notoriety. Now, I'm not going to lie. I'm going to be totally honest because that's what I do. I was fucking with China Mac way before that, bro, since New York shit, on his rap shit, hearing his story, you know, on Vlad. And I was already fucking with that cat. Like, I was already listening to some of the things he had going on. So I was aware of who he was, man. And I was aware of his, you know, the respectability on his name in the streets. You know, I understand that this fight, for YouTube purposes and for social media purposes, did kind of put him on the fast track or blow him up in the direction of respect, right? A lot of people were like, damn, man, I can't say, hey, AD's a big boy, man. China Mac, win or lose, Holmes. Win, lose, or draw. That motherfucker kept his draws on. He handled his business. And AD already had that street cred, man. And by him being on No Jumper at that time, he was at the height of No Jumper. AD is No Jumper, homie. Let's just keep it real. Before him, that channel was... After him, that channel was... Right? While he was there, it was popping, homes. That's when they were getting their most views. That's when shit was up. It was turned up in there. They were actually doing what it was meant to be. You know, interviewing righteously good people in respect, letting you hear their stories without interrupting them with them fucking porn bullshit. It was all good in the hood. And then it got real tricky, Mickey, cuz. All right. Then, you know, Adam, by whatever he chose to do that day, he was upset. Because his lady was quiet on the set, right? Handling her business. So he started to push people away for whatever reason, you know? And we started to hear about the money situations and how they were getting paid. You know, it was like a welfare department over there, you know? You only get paid on the 1st and 15th, and Adam only gets paid on the 21st. You know what it is, right? That's just how that was going. So anyways, they chose to do their own thing, man. And shit started to come out on Adam. Mysteriously, man, we started to hear about Canadian phone calls with young children, and people try to slander his name, me being one of them, right? Nah, at that time, I'm a grown man now, man. I'm not here to talk shit about Adam. If Adam wants to indulge in frivolous behavior, well, that's a grown man. He could do that. He has a lot of money and an old lady with a big ass that black guy's like. So he's going to win. Or is he? You know, cuckold is, I guess, in style now. So here's the real shit, man, without being funny. You know, when you have friends, man, there's a lot of things that get done behind the scenes, man. A lot of situations where maybe you're like, okay, let me question this a little bit. But it's not for social media. See, if you're a real one, man, if you're a real friend and you guys do real shit, you're not going to be gangster all the time. You can't expect someone to win 100% of the time. You know, maybe fucking, hey, you guys are downtown, you and the homies and shit, man, and maybe some fucking full disrespects and everyone gets off and one homeboy tripped and fell and fucking landed in a pile of dog shit, you know? And you guys are going to laugh, but it's like, hey, at least the homie tried, right? And then later on, you're going to go on the internet when you're beefing with this guy. Now it's not just you're not friends anymore, but now it's beefing. You notice how it's that? No one could just be like, oh, yeah, I don't fuck with him no more, man. We're not friends. It's cool. We're on two different paths, and what he's doing, what I'm doing, we're just not coming eye to eye on some real shit. But he's a good dude. Homes, fuck, tap in. Fuck with him, right? No. They can't do that. Hell no. They're not going to do that. Let me tell you what they're going to do. Hey, one time that motherfucker, we were all fighting, Holmes. He didn't even participate. That fool fucking, he jumped over our fence, tripped and fell in dog shit. You mean we're smoking dog shit, right? No, he was. And that's the type of shit people do, is they start exposing people. Now, Adam is feeling some type of way over this cat right here, Baby Snap, over Crip Mac. I've never in my life seen so many fucking grown men fighting over another man. This motherfucker is a volcano of bread, huh? I saw you and Crip Mac walking in the rain. It was one cuckold, one Asian, and a guy everyone calls a lame. Right, come on now, stop it, bro. There's too much going on here. Crip Mac is friends with China Mac, not because of YouTube, not because of the bullshit, because they have a bond of friendship there. Ray Charles can see that shit. Stevie Wonder, any blind person, shit, there's motherfuckers out there right now in the Deaf Academy that can hear it, you know? So it's not like they're not real friends. Adam, you are a master manipulator. That the only thing that you wanted to do was manipulate this guy, Crip Mac, and not even manipulate him, just have him ease on down the road. Have him ease on down the road to your channel, gain you a whole bunch of views, and when he truly needs you, you turn your back assist on him, right? Guard! It's fucked up, eh? It's what happens. Like I said, man, Stevie seen that coming, you know? Looking back on when I was a little nappy-headed boy, then my only worry was Adam was gonna use me for a toy. That's what Adam did. Even though I sometimes wouldn't get a thing. Fucking with Adam, you're never gonna get a thing, because I'm gonna tell you, we was always happy with what No Jumper bring. I'm gonna tell you what No Jumper brings, man. A lot of drama, a lot of people getting utilized, and a lot of bullshit. But at the end of the day, you're on some grown man shit, and if you're susceptible to being used, and you let this guy use you like a pair of old calzones, well, that's on you, man. You know, you're gonna stink at the end. So Crip Mac is locked up, and everybody, it seems like everybody is still using his name to fundamentally get some of them increments, guys, right? To which he's not getting any, but it is what it is. This is part of the game. I guess, I said a week ago, man, after a week, no one's gonna be talking about Crip Mac shit. Here I am, right? I guess his name holds weight like that. He pushed rhymes like weight. I guess he's got that going on. Whatever. I've never seen so many fucking grown men fight over his attention or who was friends with him and who had his best. You got this cat 600 who makes a video every single day. If he ain't talking about Big U, he's talking about respects to Big U, right? He's talking about fucking how he was a real friend to Crip Mac. You know, we all know that story. He was over there using and abusing him, right? But how he was a real friend. And then you got China Mac putting out real game like, hey, homie, I'm really trying to do some real shit here to help the homie get out. And then you got fucking Adam like, I ain't helping that motherfucker. Okay, maybe I will. Let me get a hold of Lupe, right? And meanwhile, Lupe's over there seawalking. There's a lot of people that want to claim the fame but don't want to get their hands dirty. Now, that's what you call Mickey Tricky, you know, Crip Mac? But there's a lot of shit being exposed in the meantime, in between time, all fighting over another man. Whole bunch of strange men fighting over a stranger man, right? It's weird. And now they're starting to expose each other, you know? It's crazy, you know, for Adam to feel that what China Mac said as far as, you know, he kept it real, bro. He put out a very respectful video, said in the beginning, and said, hey, you know, I went over here and You know, and I guess that's our problem on social media, letting everyone know everybody's business. You know, there's China Mac, he could have just said, you know what, fuck it. But he knew, come on, homie, deep down inside that if he threw something out there about Adam not wanting to participate in the court and letting everybody's, let everyone know Crit Mac and Adam's business, everybody was going to tune in. Excuse me, man. I almost threw up when I thought about that shit. Every time I say Adam's name, man, a gossip falls out of my head and it makes me want to throw up, man. It's different, right? I don't know. Maybe it's not. I've only heard of old white people doing that shit. Right? So, anyways, he could have fucking kept Adam's business, you know, in the cuts. But, you know, he chose to throw it out there. He knew it was going to gain a lot of views. And come on, man, at the end of the day, it's about getting that bag. You can't knock anyone's hustle. Everybody always talks about, like, say, Wes Watson. Oh, he made it. He made it on the backs of lies, man. And he did do that. But at the end of the day, people still respect because he had what he's doing now. He's helped many people. So you can't knock that. You know, he turned a negative into a positive. You know, he did some shit. You know, he's an energizer rabbit. He keeps going and going and going and getting bigger. So when it comes to China Matt, he did what he did. He should have never put that business out there because this started a whole situation where now you have Adam fucking mad. Oh, don't. Hey, listen. Shh. Don't make the white man mad. Because the white man march is on and Adam starts to throw everything out there. And so, you know, he called fucking China Mac a bum and you've never amounted to shit and you're nothing. And then China Mac retaliated with, oh, I was a legend in your mind, though, when you had my Chinese all up in your bumper nickels, right? All up in your gums, bumping baking soda breath. He was like, yeah. He was at the Rolling Loud, yeah, Shea Stadium, Queens, yeah. You had my Chinese dick all up in your mouth. So who's hasn't Adam had in his mouth? Or his old ladies, right? So at the same time, we can see all that back and forth, mumbo jumbo bullshit. It's good for views. It's good for content. But now Adam is exposed. Okay, yo, so you want to play for reals, right? Right? Well, you and AD didn't really fight. So now he's saying him and China Mac and AD never fought. What does that do to their credibility to say something like that, that they never fought? Because I truly believe something happened. Like I said, I don't know if it was a game of smear the queer. It could have possibly been a game of laser tag. And AD fell, rolled over, scraped his hand, and China Mac fell on his face. They were just playing laser tag, is it? Or maybe they were fucking really sitting down and went into the backyard and played in a very intense game of connect the dot. Either way, something happened, right? Something where there was two opposite sides, man, and they agreed that this was a fight. Hey, you sunk my battleship. And that was it. But for Adam to be throwing that out there now, why didn't he do that when AD was going in on him? Or, you know, and AD did it in a very fucking respectful way when he was fighting with the fit community, doing all that a couple weeks back. Why didn't he expose that then? You know, it's because he really truly has a pure hatred in his heart. He didn't really hate AD. He respects AD as a real one. He knows AD would go over there and whip his ass, right? But why does he do it to China Mac? Because he's always had a hatred in his heart towards China Mac. And he really hates the fact that China Mac is able to be a real friend with Crit Mac. And he sees the potential there, man. They're getting their increments because they're making their bread. Peanut butter, jelly, white, Wonder Bread. They're doing their thing, right? And he doesn't like that, bro. He's never liked you, China Mac. I'm not trying to stir the pot. I'm just saying it's truth. It's facts. Anyone can see it. Anyways, do you truly believe that this fight between AD and China Mac was real, that Adam Sane wasn't? And here's the real question. Does it even fucking matter? It's already been a year, 2 years. So what, Holmes? If they didn't really fight, if it was all fucking Hollywood fabricated. Half the shit that goes on right there on No Pumper is fabricated, man. It's bullshit, you know? I'm going to tell you what is real, though. I'm going to tell you what video was real. Lena getting her ass whizzed on. That bitch, she was buying the pillow, eh? That was real. That motherfucking video was A1 from day one. I seen a video where she was describing it and she said she felt bad. She was sucking another man's shoulder on. She was like, this ain't Adams, right? It's too big to be Adams, huh? Anyways, with that being said, I hope that you guys move smooth with a purpose and the drama unfolds, man. I'm not here to do chismis shit. I'm not here to talk shit. I'm just here to keep it real, man. What's your opinion on the matter? I'm going to drop another video because this frivolous ass bullshit really don't mean shit to me, man. But it's just something to throw out there. Everyone else is. Why can't the gun win one time? With that being said, I hope that you move smooth with a purpose. And remember, man, I'm not here to disrespect anyone. This is all just for entertainment value, for YouTube education. And you know what it is, man. Go out and get yours, gente. You know, it's almost Christmas time, man. Make sure that you have your family in mind and you do well, man. You don't want to fall in the trenches before Christmas, man, because he's a sly one, Mr. Grinch. Just understand that the Grinch is always around you trying to steal Christmas. So go out there, man, and really get it for your familia. With that being said, thumbs up or thumbs down. Heavy's going to be the head that wears the crown. I'm going to continue to strive, struggle, struggle, strive for what I truly believe in. And that's being as real as I can right here and providing the best content I can. Black and brown, man, and the Woods, brother. Asians, Usos, everybody. I said mine's natives. You already know what that is, man. And as far as this controversy and this bullshit going on, oh, it's going to get worse. It's going to get way worse. Next thing you know, there's going to be pictures of Adam and De La Hoya exposed wearing fishnet stockings. And then there's going to be Adam's going to bust a press conference and say, hey, you guys want to know what's up? China Mac's really Japanese. Bang, bang.